On record. Call to order the October 10th, 2016 meeting of the Lincoln City Urban Renewal Agency. Roll call, please.
Susan Walkie.
Here.
Don Williams.
Here.
Dick Anderson.
Here.
Chester Norikis.
Here.
Wes Ryan.
Here.
And Kip Ward.
Here.
This is a time for comments from citizens present, and I see none. No meetings to approve. Next item, special order of business presentations, update, project staffing, future topics. And Mr. Chandler and Ms. Robertson.
Yeah, Allison will be doing the bulk of the work on this presentation. As we made the transition to her taking over the director of this department, one of the things we've been discussing for the last several weeks is how to begin to present information to you so that, because there's quite a few things that are going to be taking place. And what we decided upon is, instead of trying to hold a big long work meeting, that the different topics could be easily spread out during your regular Urban Renewal Agency meetings, and we just take one or two topics at a time. Some of these are information that is pertinent to right now. Others will happen in the future. And so we wanted to begin today's meeting with really kind of a little bit of a summary of where we are, especially with the projects, and then to talk about some of the future agenda items that we will be discussing. And so with that, I'll turn it over to Allison, and she can take it from here.
Okay, first we'll start with updates on projects. This one was done a few months ago, but we didn't really publicly tell you it was done. This is the second phase of the Nelscott parking lot at Southwest 35th Street and 101. The project was completed on time and within budget. The first phase kicked off the improvements to Highway 101 that were made by ODOT. And this project added 10 parking spaces, landscaping, wayfinding, signage, and added connectivity to the frontage road along the historic business district, the businesses there on the west side, and then the sidewalk improvements, which were made by ODOT. This is a photo that shows the connection between the ODOT improved frontage road to the new parking lot. So looking south. And this photo is looking north, showing the connection from the new urban renewal parking lot to the exit on the frontage road to Highway 101. This shows a photo of the newly relocated accessible parking space that's nearest the Nelscott businesses. And this photo is facing east from 35th Street looking toward Highway 101. So you can see there's the exit for folks to route onto 35th Street. And lastly, this is the very last step of the project, which was an accessible bench, which took a while for us to order and get placed. But it's all ADA approved, and that was the cherry on top of the project. Next we have, yep.
How has the traffic flow been on that project?
We haven't had any complaints. I don't know if Public Works has. That's not, I'm getting the no indicator. So the traffic seems to be flowing just fine through the project. We did get one bit of feedback about some parking in the ADA space that is not correct. I guess some folks are kind of pulling in perpendicular to the ADA space because they seem to think that there's a little extra room. I can show you there. There's the photo. So on the asphalt part, some people are parking and blocking the ADA access. I don't think this is happening often, but it's happened often enough for one citizen to notice and brought it to our attention. So we've let the police chief and Public Works know, and so they'll keep an eye on it. And it's kind of tricky because when we first designed it for phase one, which was several years ago, we did design it to have three parking spaces in that section. And then things changed a little bit with the ADA code, and we needed a little more space to do a van accessible space and make sure that the grades were all correct. So this is the amount of space that we needed to take up for the accessible parking space, which is why when this one got relocated from the first phase. I don't know if you remember, but it was kind of a parallel spot, and there were bollards when the first phase was done, and then when we did the second phase, we relocated this one so it was closest to the businesses. So that's the only feedback that we've had. Mm-hmm. Okay, Schooner Point turnout. This project improves the Highway 101 turnout. It's a series of projects identified in the 2008 Cutler Community Vision and Corridor Plan, and this will be the first one to be constructed. This photo shows the project site looking west towards the Siletz Bay. And this one is looking south, showing the Siletz Bay on the right. And you can see some people might call this blighted with the gravel and the kind of divots there in the road, and it's definitely ready for some improvement. And here's a photo of what it would look like. This actually does not show the landscaped median, which would protect the turn movements from the turnout and the highway. It'll just basically add more safety to have the landscape median there. And the project will, create designated parking and also add a section of the Baywalk sidewalk. As you know, the Baywalk is the sidewalk that connects the Taft District to the Cutler District. And since the Taft Community Vision Plan in 99, we've been slowly working on installing chunks of that Baywalk so that we'll have a contiguous Baywalk along the bay from the two districts.
Madam Chair, will we be creating any access down to the bay from these?
That's not planned in this project. It's something we can look at in the future, but for now, we're just going to leave it as is.
Okay, well, I'm seeing, I don't know, is that just a piece of wood or is that a fence that conceptualized there?
Yeah, that's, it is a piece of driftwood.
Okay,
yeah.
So people could still access it. That's in the plan, just to leave it alone so they can still go down and get their shrimp. And
that's right.
Okay.
Yeah, so that the access to the bay will stay how it is now, although there are some private properties that are along there. So at the moment, there isn't public access, direct public access to the bay, so people are going across private property there.
Right.
But that's at folks' own risk. It's not a public access, but okay.
Thanks.
Yeah, that's not anything we'll be doing as part of this project. Since the project was not constructed after design was completed, that was a few years ago, then we needed to do a little redesign work, and that's been completed. The project will be bid and constructed in early 2017. So we've met recently with Public Works, and they've looked it over. We had our ADA coordinator also look it over, and we're in communication with ODOT about any final feedback and permitting, and then it'll be ready to move forward. This project also is going to wait until Public Works finishes their waterline bore, just so that for staging reasons, we're not complicating things for the contractors, and it'll just be a cleaner phasing.
Good.
Okay, moving along to the Cutler Southwest Jetty Avenue Realignment Project. This one is another project that was identified as one of the Cutler Comprehensive Plan projects. And realigning the street will improve safety, reduce traffic speeds, provide two-way street flow. Right now it's currently one way into the Cutler neighborhood, and assist private property owners with redevelopment. So you can see here, we're all pretty well familiar with Southwest Jetty. It kind of goes at a 45-degree angle from Highway 101. Most people kind of use it like a freeway off-ramp. So this will definitely tighten up the turn movement and slow traffic speeds. Here's a close-up. You can see that better.
Madam Chair.
Yes, Ms. Marakis.
Allison, how do you anticipate this might assist private property owners with redevelopment?
Well, the property where the Bay House restaurant currently sits, that property and then their parking lot, those are owned by the same person. And then the gravel area, which is on the kind of southeast side of Jetty, is also owned by them. So right now, Southwest Jetty kind of bisects their property. So if we can move that around and tighten it up to where the crab pot used to be, then that will actually benefit the crab pot property owner by having a street frontage. Oh, thank you. And then it will also benefit the other private property owners on the Bay House side of the street.
Thank you.
Right, so this gravel area right here, and this parking lot, and here's the Bay House. Those three are owned by the same people. And then I'll show you here. Here is the new proposed concept. So existing jetty, and then proposed jetty. And you can see here is the crab pot. This is an aerial before the fire. And it would actually bring a driveway right here on jetty so that this property owner can access their property in the back rather than on Highway 101. And then it would increase the development potential for the properties here.
Good. Thank you.
And Madam Chair, mm-hmm. I'm sorry, I guess I had too much to do this week and I didn't get to look at this. So we're going to close jetty?
We're not going to close jetty. We're going to move it.
Okay. And where it exists now will no longer be a street.
That's correct.
Who will own that property?
We will basically trade. So where jetty...
So we're going to make the 45.
Yeah, the old jetty and the new jetty are currently, you know, the public right-of-way of the old jetty. We will trade it for private property to put the new jetty, and we'll give up the old jetty to those property owners, basically trading.
And do we need to involve ODOT? Are they aware?
They have been involved, yes. They met with us and with the property owners, more than just these two. We had five different property owners there to discuss with ODOT what options they'd like to see, and we had some early concept development done, and that's kind of where we're at now. So the next step would be to move into design and engineering. This is not surveyed, so this is very conceptual, and I think everyone's happy with this, so this is kind of the direction that we would go from here.
Mm-hmm.
Are there any other questions on this one?
Would we see any more development of sidewalks there?
Yeah, we would need to connect the sidewalk. Right now there is sidewalk along jetty,
right.
So we would basically build sidewalk with the new jetty.
Good.
And build a full street per the public work standards.
Good. Okay.
Good. Okay.
Madam Chair. Allison, I went back on the budget, and because I'm always curious, where are we on the status of projects? And budget's always a nice starting spot. And I see all these projects, this one and the turnout, certainly were on the budget when we approved it in June.
Mm-hmm.
For this next fiscal year. But has there been any other process of approving these projects? And prior to the budget, these projects have been on a long list for a long time,
mm-hmm.
and not moved to the next step. I'm just either missing a beat, and that's real easy. When did we move these into the get it ready for bid mm-hmm. process?
Yeah, I think we did that with the budget process, and the understanding was that with the bond sale that we'll talk about as part of the future project topics, this one cannot be built until that bond sale happens. So the design was in with the budget, but not the construction.
Okay.
So
we will, I do see on the agenda, we'll get to the, maybe, I want to make sure that other projects that we either delayed or went mm-hmm. further are included.
Yes.
So I'm
absolutely. Yeah, we'll have a full discussion about what projects you want to move forward. There are three projects in Cutler City which we presented a couple of years ago with that budget, and then our current budget discussion as well. And that's the jetty sidewalk, jetty realignment, the Baywalk sidewalk, and the turnout. And those three would provide contiguous Baywalk from the bridge down into the Cutler District. So those were kind of all three brought forward in discussion as a series of projects. So, okay. Are there any other questions on this one?
Sure. bike lanes would be included in that too, right?
Not in this, not in the jetty realignment, because this is our, this isn't an ODOT project, this is our project, so it's really a lower volume street, smaller street, so most of the time, the bicycles will just kind of stay in the drive lane. They could also ride on the sidewalk, but it's...
No, I understand.
There won't be a separate bike lane. We're really trying to keep the street width as small as possible, because we want to be able to maximize the redevelopment potential for the private property owners as well, so...
It's just on my wish list, and I understand what ODOT's decision is. That area is flat.
Yes, it is.
You've got a lot of flat land from once you pass the, in the Spanish Head. Biking and walking is perfect, so we want to do everything we can to encourage it down there.
Definitely. Well, we could talk about including sharrows, so that there are markings. We could talk to Public Works about getting that.
And the wayfinding is a great thing to do.
Okay. Any other comments on this one? No? Okay. All right, so this is that third project, Mr. Anderson, the Baywalk sidewalk. So this photo right here is looking to the south, and this would design a section of remaining sidewalk gap to connect the Schooner Point turnout with the ODOT improved turnout just south of the Schooner Creek Bridge. So there are two turnouts. One of them, ODOT has made improvements a couple of different times, and you're just kind of seeing the south part of that turnout there with their fencing. And then here you can see this is kind of the existing condition, and it's unprotected pedestrian and bicycle space adjacent Highway 101. And this is the section of highway is the only route for all modes of transportation between Taft and Keller City. So it's a pretty important section. Let's see. So we will also partner in communications with ODOT about road conditions before proceeding with design. So at this point, we have a very cursory, I'd say maybe like 10% design concept that shows some of the placement of the Baywalk. And at this point, we want to make sure from ODOT that they are aware of this kind of slide area. You can see there's a fence. There's a fence post, there's the concrete, and then the fence that has kind of swept down, and then there's another post down here. So that fence that I showed you right here has, this is a good area, but just around this bend, it's a little bit constricted. And so we want to make sure that we've had conversations with them about what their plans are and if there's some additional stability that is needed. Okay, Wacoma Northwest Jetty Sewer Line. So this is a Public Works partnership project, and the Wacoma District saw major upgrades to the West Devils Lake Road pump sanitary sewer lift station in 2014, and there were subsequent plans to increase the capacity of the force main connecting the Widler station to the Wacoma lift stations, as you may recall. However, it was determined the force main upgrade was not necessary, and those funds were then allocated to the replacement of a section of gravity sewer, which was the final step of upgrading this part of the city sewer system. And there's an after picture. And there's another photo looking the other direction. So the project was identified as an underlevy plan project. So this was part of our kind of our deal of sharing our funding in our last 10 years that we are allowed to continue collecting that last increment. And Public Works brought the project in under budget. It was about $825,000 and 30 days ahead of schedule. So that one went very well. This is the second Public Works partnership project. This is the Roads End South lift station. And this one went through preliminary design process that anticipated exceeding the funding available from urban renewal, and city funds to make up the difference were not available. The design team was able to do modifications to the design that reduced the cost while still increasing the capacity. The agency has earmarked $1,095,000 in additional capital reserve for this project. So we have the funds ready and waiting. We just needed to wait for that design team to make a few refinements. And here's a picture of the interior, existing. And so I believe that one is soon to be bid? Yeah, that one will be bid in the near future. Oh, that's right, thank you. So the ball is in DEQ's court on approving the design. And then once we have that, then Public Works will move that for bidding. Property management. So while most of the agency-owned property that we have is vacant, two of the properties have buildings and longstanding tenants. Staff is working to update and renew leases for the Lincoln City Glass Center in Taft and for the Lincoln City Cultural Center in Dee Lake. These will come before you for formal adoption later this year. That's something we've been working on.
Madam Chair, could you go back a slide, sure. Allison, please? That looks brand new. That looks like in awfully good shape. What are we going to be doing to that?
Well, it's indoor, so it hasn't had any salt air on it. Do you want to talk a little bit about?
So there's a couple things. The pumps are out of date. They do look in good shape above ground. The housing is in good shape. Again, it is protected. But we're going to be replacing the pumps. We're going to be increasing the capacity of the wet well. We're going to be updating the generator and adding new controls.
Okay.
So the guts is still going to stay the same. The configuration is going to be very similar. Mm-hmm. And that's how we wanted to redesign it so we could stay within the footprint and use what is good there. So
great. Thank you.
Okay, so some other updates. On February 22nd, staff was directed to negotiate and acquire a small piece of property for public benefit, and we just wanted to let you know all that paperwork is complete. We're just waiting now for the seller's signatures in order to complete that, and then we'll bring that back and let you know that was done. And then, as you know, staff's been transitioning after the retirement of Director Kurt Olson, and as of today, our HR director has an accepted job offer for the part-time administrative coordinator position, which will start at the end of October. So we're very excited about that. And moving on to future topics. As Mr. Chandler mentioned, over the next few months, staff will bring forward the following topics for discussion and some decisions. These topics include the timing for the final bond for the agency's existing urban renewal district and prioritizing projects based on the last remaining funds. We will also explore creating another district to fund future improvements, and we will have a presentation on the loan programs and talk about privacy in the application process. And economic development is another topic that we will bring back, and it's got some subtopics. For example, a city plan and strategy is needed after the planning department completes the first phase of the comprehensive plan update, which includes the housing needs assessment, the buildable lands inventory, and the economic opportunities analysis. Staff will also bring back the agency's economic development toolbox. As you know, there are about 22 tools in there and possibly more that you'd like to see hit the ground and develop. And let's see, the concept of a business incubator, similar to the Glass Studio, could be another type of economic development tool. Lastly, we'll need to refine our strategy with property development for the four agency-owned parcels. We are getting closer to getting the property line survey points from ODOT. As you know, for the Nelscott property, we bought those properties with the anticipation of rerouting 32nd Street, and we're just waiting for ODOT to have that recorded with the county. They've done their part, but we're waiting for the county now. And as soon as we get that, we'll have a more accurate idea of what that property is, how many acres it is, and then how much development potential it has. So we're kind of waiting for all four to be ready, and then we'll be talking to you about getting a little more clarity on what exactly we're going to be looking for. So,
Madam Chair,
The property up, as you come off of 29th going up Dune, where the houses were built and then torn down?
Yes.
Who owns that piece of land now?
I believe ODOT owns those. I don't know. That's a good question. I can look into that. I know they purchased them in order to do the retaining wall and have enough clearance to do their fencing for safety, but I don't know how much, if any of it, they've given back, and if they are giving any of it back, who they're giving it to, if it's just going into public right-of-way or going to the city. That's a good question.
Seems a fairly useful lot. It's an odd one, but it's, mm-hmm. it's still useful.
Okay, I'll look into that.
Okay, thank you.
Are there any other questions?
Madam Chair?
Yes.
I always get nervous when things don't show up in print. Mm-hmm. So thank you for at least talking about the four properties. How do we as an agency emphasize enough that, you know, it needs to, in my opinion, it needs to move up and on the activity list? And I don't even know what I'm saying when I say that, because I don't know what else we could do. But I'm fearful that, you know, another year goes by and we talk the same thing, that it's there, you know, we intend to. So I don't know what it takes, Madam Chair, but I would hope that we could either as agency members assist, you know, if needed, to do something to get it, because I think it would show real full circle activity if this plan, agency urban renewal plan, actually sold some property too and got it back into development prior to exploring a second urban renewal district.
One of the key things that we will discuss with you is a matter of policy, is how to go forward with that. The traditional way is that we would put it up for sale, we would accept bids, and if somebody bid on it, then we'd determine whether or not we would sell it to them, and we do that on an individual property by property basis. The second method to do is to, instead of marketing each piece of property separately, is to market that the city has property to sell and then go out and looking for people who might be interested in developing, and through that looking, identify which property best meets their desires. And so one of our discussions that we'll have is how do you go about doing those two methods, and which, and what are the pluses and minuses and advantages and disadvantages of each method. So we will be seeking a little bit of guidance from you as we come back in a future discussion.
Thank you.
Any other questions? Comments? Okay. Thank you for the outline. What's ahead for us?
Actually, Madam Chair, I do have a question. It's kind of off topic since we're kind of ahead of schedule here. If I might ask, the dock. That's all public works. It's nothing to do with urban renewal?
It is.
Okay. Well, then I have no question.
All right. Any other comments?
Madam Chair, and I guess since you brought up the ADA kind of topic, as I'm remembering, this year we kind of looked for, in urban renewal, low-hanging fruit where we could work ADA corrections from our previous inspections into some of these projects. So I'm assuming sidewalk dollars would be going towards that allocation. Is there anything specific on the horizon, since the projects you talked today are new projects, new concrete, anything jumping up that would be fixing some ADA discoveries or needs?
Yeah, I think you're exactly right with the new projects. We're building it up to current ADA specifications. It is an ADA improvement because there isn't a facility there now. We're also keeping in mind with bench placement, there has to be a 3x4 pad next to it so someone can be sitting next to someone on a bench, and there are lots of things like that that we have been incorporating into our projects. I can't think of any at the moment where we will be redoing anything, but it's definitely something that's on the forefront of our projects.
We have several ADA improvements that are a part of the budget, and so if you'll give me a little bit of time, I can get a report to you on that.
Well, even as I ask it, Madam Chair, I'm sorry, I think I'm ahead of the game, you know, my own thought that I'm betting if Public Works identifies, they might be coming to you for sharing in the cost. So it would be they who would be identifying the projects anyways. Yeah.
We'll put together an update on that and send it to you.
Thank you.
Mr. Nikas?
Allison, on the Southwest 35th Street parking lot, how did we do budget-wise with that project and time-wise?
That's a great question. This was not a usual project. This project, we were first in construction-wise. We started around the same time that ODOT started their two-year construction project, except they were on the north end of their project, and when they and Public Works were doing their utility relocates, that's when we were starting about that time. And everything went within budget. There were a few things that happened that were unexpected, and so those kind of came in as emergency sorts of things. We had a few thousand to K&E excavating a couple of times because there was a stormwater issue. So because it was phase one and it wasn't a finalized project, it was kind of half a project or 75% of a project, then we got this crazy rainstorm, and the business owner that's right next to the parking lot was experiencing a lot of water kind of coming towards the building, and so we needed to expedite putting in a storm basin, a catch basin, to address that. So there were some things that way, and then also because we were first in and then ODOT came in, you know, we had to put in bollards so that which we wouldn't normally have to do. We would normally build a complete project. And then when ODOT came in and did their project and left, we were able to see more accurately where the elevation points were, where we had to tie back in. And so there was a little bit of design and engineering finessing that needed to happen. We also went through two site plan reviews because we had a phase one and a phase two. So it's all in all, it went very well, and it was within the approved allocated budgeted amount for NELSCOT. But I'd prefer not to do that kind of a project again. We like to really get in and get out and have as little impact as possible, and this was challenging in that regard. So.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
No public hearings, no resolutions, no further agency member comments. We're adjourned. Oh, yes.